Hi guys, let's have a discussion. Today's set of questions starts with the one on sovereign gold bonds. Whom the following is eligible to buy sovereign gold bonds? Well, everyone listed there, you know, is eligible. So you could buy, Hindu undivided families could buy, and trust charitable institutions also can buy. Let's take some notes on sovereign gold bonds. Please write SGB, or you write in full, sovereign gold bonds. Underline that. One, bonds issued by the RBI on behalf of the government of India. Next, government, second point, government security. So just a second, we are going to write this in easy to understand bhasha. We are not taking grammar or anything, okay? Basic facts. Number two, government security denominated 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 in multiples of grams of gold. Next point, substitute for investment in physical gold. Next, to buy the bond, comma, an investor has to pay issue price in cash to a registered SEBI broker. SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India. SEBI broker. Full stop. Next point. Gold bonds, sovereign gold bonds, are listed and traded on National Stock Exchange. Next, on redemption, 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 in brackets, sale or date of maturity, is actually no maturity, it's sale basically, on redemption, cash is deposited into the investor's bank account. Next, bonds bear an interest rate of 2.5% per annum, paid an interest rate of 2.5% per annum, in brackets, paid off yearly, that's in brackets. So an interest rate of 2.5% paid off yearly on nominal value. So whatever the value of the bond is, on that 2.5% interest is paid. Last one, investors will also earn returns. Investors can also earn returns linked to gold prices. Gold prices. So there is, let's say you have money and you want to invest in sovereign gold bonds. So instead of buying gold, because even there is physical gold, you need to store it, you need to store it safely. So a lot of people basically invest in gold. Let me tell you something about gold. A lot of people invest in gold because people believe that gold is the best hedge. It's highly liquid. It's highly liquid. It's something that people could, you know, people could sell any time to raise money if they are in financial difficulty. Now the idea here is that when people do not want to buy physical gold, there are other avenues. So the government says, why buy physical gold? Because when you have gold with you, physical gold, let's say this is physical gold. No, does it earn any money? No, it doesn't earn any money. So it sits at home in a locker. Okay, in an almirah it sits. Does it earn interest? No, it doesn't earn interest. So the government, and plus there is a safety issue. So government says, why buy gold? And you may say, no, I want to buy jewels so that my, you know, when my daughter grows up, or my wife, or my wife, my mother, my sister, I would buy jewels. The government says, hey, why? The government doesn't say it, but I am saying it in this way. Why buy jewels? Why get jewels? See, jewels have manufacturing cost, making charges, they call them. Then they have, you know, wastage. And at the time of sale, see, there are stones in gold, you know, like, let's say necklace make gold, stones with them, you know, some stones, diamonds or whatever stones, American diamonds, false stones. At the time of sale, the value of those stones is all removed. So the kind of money people make on sale of gold also is not great. Unless there is extreme emergency, people don't sell gold. That's the case in India. But in all, gold as a jewel is not a great asset. You know, in terms of jewelry, it's not a great asset. So the government says, why not invest in gold bonds? Just say, you know, you buy gold bonds at, you know, so and so price. This is linked to the gold market price. So the price of the bond goes up if the price of the gold in the market also increases. So you can earn there, plus you can also earn 2.5% interest. And typically the government sells these bonds at a discount. So in, let's say the value is, let's say today's gold value is 40,000 rupees per 10 grams, or let's say 4,000 per gram, 4,000 per gram. The government says, okay, not 4,000, you pay something like 3,800 rupees, we'll give you 5% discount. So you pay 3,800 rupees, current market value is 4,000 rupees, so you already earned 5%, and tomorrow the value goes up, again you will earn more, okay? Plus your 2.5% on, you know, in terms of interest. So you earn well, but then, you know, people always have this, you and I live in a society that loves gold to, you know, in terms of demonstration, in terms of the demonstration effect it has. Log sona pehante, kafi pehante, you know, shadiyon mein jaate, people go to attend wedding functions and all. So they lace themselves with gold. Now the idea is, and especially if you see in South India, that gold fondness, love of gold is much greater, especially to show it off. It's there everywhere, but especially in South India, especially in Kerala. Okay, my Malayali friends who are watching this would understand, would agree with me. So the idea is that instead of investing like this, we could as well buy these bonds, and this money would go to the government, which the government would use to create infrastructure, you know, whatever the government's expenses are, especially to create infrastructure. Okay, so what's the minimum? You write minimum investment - 1 gram for any category of investors. 1 gram for any category of investors. So the minimum that an HUF, a trust, or an individual can buy is 1 gram. Next, what's the maximum? Maximum 4 kg per annum per individual and per HUF, Hindu undivided family.
Hindu undivided family. Hindu undivided family has a head. The head of the HUF is called Karta. So the maximum that an HUF can invest in these gold bonds is buying 4 kg of them. Okay. Next, 25 kgs for trust. 20 kgs for trust. 20 kgs for trust and charity institutes. Charitable institutions. Now, that's a little about the gold bonds. I don't think I need to discuss more. But ek baat hai ki kahin somewhere I read that, you know, in the past people would wear a gold ring, you know, for one major issue, especially in the old times, people used to wear a gold ring as, you know, especially if they were traveling. In case they would lose their luggage or their belongings, they could still sell this ring, get some money and come back home. That was the objective of the gold ring. Of course, now meanings have changed. Yeah, meanings have changed. So I also, you know, there is some feedback that we received, and this is from Kaushik Kotra. He sent feedback yesterday on 14th. The feedback was that the full form of CSIR has been given as Council for Scientific and Industrial Relations. It is incorrect. You know, it's not relations. As you rightly pointed out, it is research. I'm sorry for the error. Kaushik and everyone else here, it is the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. That is the full form of CSIR. CSIR. Thanks, Kaushik. You know, sometimes these kinds of things, while complex things, I normally don't go wrong, but you know, where things they are very easy, where the spellings are very easy, I fumble. Okay. But otherwise, it is the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR. Thanks once again, Kaushik, and everyone else out there, my apologies. So from there, the next question. On 14th July, which country banned, 14th July of this year, which country banned Huawei? You can say, pronounce it as Huawei or Huawei. You can pronounce it with an H or with an U, with the H being silent. On 14th July, which country banned Huawei or Huawei from participating in its 5G networks? 5G networks, fifth generation mobile networks. So Great Britain decided that it will not allow China to participate in its 5G networks, because countries now are building 5G networks. And Britain doesn't want Chinese company Huawei to invest in technology and bring in that technology, to become a partner with any British company. Why? Because see, before this, before Britain, America had banned Huawei. Huawei is a Chinese company, which is a pioneer company. It's not a gully corner company ke bhai chalo isko ban kar diya kuch farak nahi padega. No. I would want you to write about Huawei 2-3 things, and then we will discuss this further. Please write Huawei. Huawei. Underline that. First point. Founded 1987. Second point. Current chairman and founder. Current chairman and company founder. Dash. Ren Zhengwei. R-E-N. Ren. I spell it again. R-E-N. Ren Zhengwei. Z-H-E-N-G-H-F-E-I. To repeat. Z-H-E-N-G-H-F-E-I. Ren Zhengwei. In some places you may not find the second H. After G ke baad H nahi milega aapko, koi baat nahi, dono sahi hai. Okay. Ren Zhengwei. He is a current chairman. He is a current CEO and founder. He is the guy who founded the company. Earlier he worked for, you know, the People's Liberation Army of what we say, China. He was a PLA member. Then he left the PLA and started this company. And it is for this reason that the Chinese government, the countries all over the world, even India is quite worried about this. India will, to a large extent, not allow Huawei to participate in 5G networks. Already, I'll tell you why. Before that, why countries are quite cautious of this particular, allowing this particular company? Because it's backed by the Chinese government. And everything that comes from China, remember, if it's a private company like Huawei is, on paper it's private, but to a large extent, it's controlled by the Chinese government. And remember one thing, all the Chinese companies that have done well in the world, WeChat, okay, TikTok, are all backed by the Chinese government. Because if they are backed by the Chinese government, they are able to do well. Otherwise, in China, you cannot do well if you don't have the support of the Chinese government. So what does Chinese government get in return? All data that's available on the networks of these apps. For example, in Huawei network, everything that is there in the networks, 5G networks, 4G network, whatever network, telecommunications network they have built, all the data is taken, you know, is caught, rather taken by Chinese government. आपका पूरा टिकटॉक डेटा, आपके फोन नंबर, आपके कॉन्टैक्ट्स, जो भी है आपके फोन के ऊपर, जो भी है, वट एवर इज देयर ऑन योर फोन, इफ यू हैव टिकटॉक ऑन दिस फोन, वट एवर इज देयर, ऑल बैंक अकाउंट्स, एवरीथिंग इज कैप्चर्ड बाय द चाइनीज गवर्नमेंट. इनफैक्ट दे कैन इंटरसेप्ट ऑल द मैसेजेस, ओके, एंड आई एम नॉट किडिंग एट ऑल. ऑल डेटा इज विद देम. दे कैन यूज माय फोन फॉर सम अदर पर्पस. And not just this, there is a major issue here. See, in India, we are slowly moving away without saying no to Huawei. Indian companies will not give contract to this company. You know why? See, as of today, Reliance Jio has an investor. 3 days back, an American company called Qualcomm is an American telecommunications giant. It is the owner of the CDMA technology, code division multiple access technology. You know, there are two major kinds of telecommunications, signal networks. One is GSM, the other is CDMA, okay? GSM is Global System for Mobile Communication. Second one is CDMA, code division multiple access. पहले जो टाटा इंडिकॉम वगैरह फोन होते थे, रिलायंस के पुराने फोन, पुराना रिलायंस, ओके, व्हेन धीरूभाई अंबानी वाज देयर, दे लॉन्च दिस, दैट वाज ऑल CDMA. बट आज जो है, इट्स ऑल GSM, इट्स ऑल ग्लोबल सिस्टम फॉर मोबाइल कम्युनिकेशन. सो Qualcomm इज ऑल्सो अ मेजर इन 5G टेक्नोलॉजी, नाउ इमेजिन इफ Qualcomm कम्स इन एज एन इन्वेस्टर इन Jio, will Jio go with Huawei? No, it won't. And this is where the government of India is slowly pushing Indian companies through backdoor channels, but aisa kijiye, this is what you should do and all. So to a large extent, you know, this is how companies are being forced by the government of India, or you could say not exactly forced, but prodded, requested by the government of India to work in national interest. Otherwise, how much did Qualcomm bring? Hardly 750 crore rupees. You understand that? Yes, just 750 crore rupees. That's the investment of Qualcomm in Jio. Whereas Facebook had invested 44,000 crore rupees. Whereas Google, just today in the Reliance AGM, this is being recorded one day before this, okay? You know, the Google has said that they will invest, you know, 33,700 crore in Reliance Industries, in Reliance Jio. Imagine the money they are bringing. Where is 700 crores compared to those 30,000-40,000 crore rupees? So it's not much, but what Qualcomm brings in is its expertise in 5G, and that is what Reliance is going to do, you know, use to build a 5G network. Got it? Yeah. See, I work very differently from, I don't read TV, I don't watch TV channels. Okay, I don't have subscription to any TV channel, and I don't get newspapers. But I read, when I read, I make analysis of what I read. Today, AGM just happened. In fact, it happened a couple of hours, till about, you know, it was happening a while ago. So the idea is, when you read, you should be able to connect the dots. Okay? So please know that. Now, another thing Huawei is another thing about Huawei is this, that its CFO Meng Wanzhou is a woman and is a daughter of the founder. She was arrested in Canada. She was arrested in Canada even though she had permanent residency of Canada. She had come from China, and when she came from China, she was arrested in China, Canada, at the request of the US government, because Huawei is building a network in Iran, with which, you know, against Iran, America has sanctions. So very simple, if a company violates American laws, including sanctions, then it is liable for punishment. And this is where Huawei's, you know, CFO, Meng Wanzhou, was arrested. She's still in jail, still in jail. Because she was in jail, she has been in jail for some time now, over almost a year, I think. Yeah, two Canadians have been arrested in China for no fault of theirs, but they have been charged with stealing state secrets. This is how the Chinese government works. It's a criminal network in China. Now, I've spent nearly 25 years of my life on this, learning about China. So it's not a country you can trust. You can't trust China because it doesn't trust its own citizens. Anything that citizens do is taken care of by the government, basically. Yeah, the government spies on everything. So Britain, they were yesterday banned Huawei. And second thing they said is, China said, okay, you have to pay a price. We will force you to pay a price. China takes revenge. China always takes revenge. Okay. So that's a little about Huawei. But read, my dear, you are preparing your future, and you got to prepare for a future in the best possible way. That is through building learning skill. Learning and building skill. Two things. Build learning, build skill. Okay. Australia is an enemy of China. Taiwan is an enemy of China. Canada has become an enemy of China. Finland, to a large extent, won't go with any Chinese company because it is home to Nokia, and Nokia is a 5G player. Okay, so you can see basically. Okay, from here, let's go to next one. Okay, Huawei ki head office, you want to write one last thing. Huawei head office, Shenzhen, S-H-E-N-Z-H-E-N, S-H-E-N-Z-H-E-N, Shenzhen. Shenzhen. Next. South Africa has three capitals, which is the only Indian state to have three capitals. I think we mentioned this, but a nice question. Andhra Pradesh has three capitals. What are the three capitals? But before that, South Africa has three capitals. South Africa ki capitals, right? South Africa's capitals. Right, South Africa's capitals. Dash. Pretoria. P-R-E-T-O-R-I-A, Pretoria, P-R-E-T-O-R-I-A, Pretoria, dash, executive, that the government sits there, executive, E-X-E-C-U-T-I-V-E, executive capital. Next, Cape Town, two words, Cape, C-A-P-E, Cape Town, T-O-W-N, Cape Town, dash, legislative, L-E-G-I-S-L-A-T-I-V-E, legislative. Next, third one, Bloemfontein, I'll spell it, B-L, I repeat, B-L-O-E-M-F-O-N-T-E-I, Bloemfontein. Okay, dash, judicial, J-U-D-I-C-I-A-L, judicial, that is where the Supreme Court of South Africa sits. Next, leave one line space, right? Andhra Pradesh, dash, Amaravati is legislative, have we already spelt it, legislative, comma, Visakhapatnam, Vishakhapatnam. Executive. And Karnool. Judicial.
Okay, do you know the capitals of these places? Telangana, Hyderabad, Gujarat, Gandhinagar, Haryana, Chandigarh, Maharashtra, Mumbai.
Okay. Nagpur is also seen as the second capital.
Okay.
What is the maximum denomination of a currency note that can be printed by the RBI?
10,000.
You can have a max of 10,000 rupee note in India. So we have had 2,000, even 10,000 can come. But that the government normally wouldn't come.
Yeah.
Because it could lead to black money, you know, explosion in black money.
Next.
In July 2020, which two nations joined the European Exchange Rate Mechanism to the first major step in their adoption of the euro? Euro is a currency that's, as of today, accepted by about 19 states in the European Union. 19. So, Eurozone mein 19 desh hain, and Bulgaria and Croatia have agreed to, you know, adopt euro. They want to adopt euro. But uske liye I think we can do one thing. Shall we write the capitals or the leaders or both? So let's start. Bulgaria dash. We'll write capital and whatever is possible, yeah, whatever is available in the brain, you know, we'll write. Bulgaria dash Sofia, S-O-F-I-A, Sofia dash PM is Boris Boyko, Boris, you can say Boris also, B-O-R-I-S, Boris Boyko, B-O-Y-K-O, Boris Boyko, currencies dash current currency, LEV. Okay, next. Croatia. Capital Zagreb. Z-A-G-R-E-B. Z-A-G-R-E-B. Zagreb dash Andrej Plenković. Prime Minister Andrej. A-N. D-R-E-Z or E-J, both are fine. A-N-D-R-E-J, Andrej Plenković, P-L-E-N-K-O-V-I-C, Plenković, sound aana chahiye last name, okay, Plenković. Currency, Kuna, K-U-N-A, Kuna. Next, Estonia is there in up there in on the border with Russia. It's a Baltic state. Pass by Baltic Sea hai isliye. Okay, so Estonia dash, what's the capital? Tallinn, T-A-L-L-I-N-N. I repeat, T-A-L-L-I-N-N. Tallinn dash Prime Minister Zuri Retas. Zuri, J-U-R-I, J-U-R-I, Zuri Retas, R-A-T-A-S, Retas, Zuri Retas dash Euro. It's a Euro country. Zuri Retas. Next, Latvia. They're all sworn enemies of Russia. Latvia, Estonia, uske paas ek aur desh hai, Lithuania, Tino. They're anti-Russia. That's why they moved. See, they were all parts of the USSR. In 91, they became independent. And since then, they have been moving towards, in the beginning, they moved towards European Union. And finally, they got a chance, they became a member of European Union. So as to stay away from Russia. Latvia dash currency is capital is Riga, R-I-G-A, Riga. Currency? Prime Minister. Christianis Karins, I'll spell. Christianis, K-R-I-S-J-A-N-I-S. Christianis Karins, K-A-R-I-N-S, Karins. Christianis Karins, dash, Euro. Euro. Next, which is me? Sweden, Denmark, you would know anyway. We discussed this in the past. Hungary, Bulgaria, Croatia, Serbia discuss karte hain. Hungary karte hain? Chalo, Hungary. Hungary, because they don't have Euro. Hungary, dash. Budapest, B-U-D-A-P-E-S-T. Budapest, B-U-D-A-P-E-S-T, Budapest, dash. Viktor Orban, Viktor, V-I-K-T-O-R, Viktor Orban, O-R-B-A-N-N, O-R-B-A-N-N. Sometimes you will find a single N in the end, both are fine. In some ways it's written O-R-B-A-N, sometimes with a double N. Cool, it's a proper noun. Dash, what's the currency? Forint, F-O-R-I-N-T, Forint. F-O-R-I-N-T, Forint. A last country, okay? Serbia. The capital is Belgrade, B-E-L-G-R-A-D-E, Belgrade. B-E-L-G-R-A-D-E, Belgrade. Belgrade. The president is Aleksandar Vučić. Aleksandar, A-L-E-X-A-N-D-E-R. Aleksandar. We write with an X, they write with a K. K-S. Chill. A-L-E-X-A-N-D-E-R, Aleksandar Vučić, V-U-C-I-C. Currency? Dinar, D-I-N-A-R, Dinar. D-I-N-A-R. Chaliya, I think, lot of countries here. Sweden, Denmark, some other time. Prominent countries, so not much worry. Moderna, at the forefront of developing a vaccine for COVID-19, belongs to America. It's not a public company. It's kind of a startup, you can say, actually. So, who is the CEO of this company? You could write. Moderna, dash. Where is the head office? Right. Head office. Cambridge. C-A-M-B-R-I-D-G-E. C-A-M-B-R-I-D-G-E, Cambridge, comma, Cambridge is a town in the American state of Massachusetts. It's on the east coast of America. Massachusetts, I'll spell it for you. M-A-S-S-A-C-H-U-S-E-T-T-S, Massachusetts. Massachusetts. CEO. Stephanie Bancel, I'll spell S-T-E-P-H-A-N-E. To repeat, S-T-E-P-H-A-N-E, Stephanie Bancel, B-A-N-C-E-L, Stephanie Bancel. Okay, so even in India, we have started, human trials of the COVID vaccine. Two companies have come up. One is Bharat Biotech, the other is Zydus Cadila. Zydus, Zydus Cadila, C-A-D-I-L-A. That's one company, Zydus Cadila. The other is Bharat Biotech. So these two companies have come up with the vaccine. They are advanced stages, the human trial stages. Okay, actually, we will not discuss these choices. Is there anything else? According to Transparency International Corruption Perception Index, which is the most corrupt country in the world? That's a good question. Somalia, this report was released in January this year, January 2020. Okay, so current affairs for us. Somalia is the world's most corrupt country, rank 180. ये जो rank countries हैं, Somalia, South Sudan, Syria, Yemen, Venezuela, these are the bottom five countries, 180, 179, 178, 177, 176. Okay, so which are the most honest countries? There is no perfect country, but then you know the countries that near perfect, zero corruption, almost zero corruption. Okay, so you write top five ranked countries. Baad mein aap likh lijiye Transparency International CPI. 1. Denmark. 2. New Zealand. 3. Finland. 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 4. Singapore. 5. Sweden. So Denmark, what is that? Denmark, New Zealand, Finland, Singapore, and Sweden. So you know these five countries. In some places, some sources, you will find that both New Zealand and Denmark are ranked one because they have the same score, 87 on 100. Okay, but if you go to the website of CPI, Transparency International, this particular website, this organization's website, you'll find that, you know, rank 1 is given to Denmark, rank 2 is given to New Zealand. They, on their website, are given. Whereas some organizations, some news channels and everything, they have come up, some news, you know, websites, they have come up with their own rankings. That both, because they have the same ranking, same points, they should be ranked 1. No. I'm going with this organization's ranking. Okay, so you could check. I'll just give the capitals because we already discussed the previous question, but remember, I'll bring this in the next session. You know, see, it's very easy to tell you the presidents. Muhammad Abdullahi for Somalia, South Sudan, Salwa Kiir, Mayardit, Syria, Bashar al-Assad, Yemen, Abd Mansur Rabu, yeah, or Abd Rabu Mansur, Venezuela, Nicolas Maduro. For now, not required. Just write capitals. Somalia, Mogadishu, Mogadishu, Mogadishu. South Sudan, Zuba. Syria, Damascus, Damascus, Damascus. Yemen, Yemen's capital is Sana'a, S-A-N-A-A, Sana'a. Venezuela, Caracas, C-A-R-A-C-A-S, Caracas. Kabhi kabhi kya information overload ho jata hai, isliye thoda I try to cut it down. Okay, ultra corrupt countries, my friends. Electoral bonds are valid for dash 15 days from the date of their issue. Shall we write some notes on electoral bonds? Please write electoral bond scheme 2018, or simply write electoral bond scheme. Electoral bond scheme. Underline that first point. Can be purchased by any citizen of India. By any citizen of India or any organization established by law, established by Indian law, established by Indian law. Next, an individual can buy, an individual can buy an electoral bond, can buy electoral bonds. You can write an EB, or if you want to write in short form, EB kafi hai. An individual can buy EB individually or together with others. So singly the person can buy, or jointly with others, or together with others. Next, only political parties, this is very important, only political parties which secured S-E-C-U-R-E-D, secured not less than 1% of the total votes polled in the last general election, in brackets, parliamentary or state assembly, that is Lok Sabha or state assembly, in the last general election, shall be eligible to receive electoral bonds. Next, can be encashed by a political party only through their bank account. Only through their bank account. Next, EB is valid, electoral bond is valid for 15 days from the date of its issue and no payment shall be made if it expires. EXPIRES. Do you think a political party will let it expire? Last point, the account is credited on the same day, because it's more like a prepaid instrument. Okay, so that's little about electoral bonds. So we discussed sovereign gold bonds, we discussed electoral bonds and Transparency International, we discussed Huawei, plenty of good stuff in this class. Which institution released the report titled 2020 Global Education Monitoring Report, which is like inclusion education, which is subtitled inclusion in education, all means all, UNESCO of course. So ek ek kaam karte hain, fatafat one two lines about each of this, please write. UNESCO, you know the full form, na? United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, you know this, we discussed it in the past. So Paris, Audrey Azoulay, A-U-L-A-Y, Audrey, Audrey, A-U-D-R-E-Y, Audrey, Azule, A-Z-O-U-L-A-Y, Audrey Azule, in brackets, France, France, she's from France. You want the head office? Paris, Paris, Paris. So, look at the first one, ILO, International Labour Organization, International Labour Organization, dash, International Labour Organization, dash, 1919, dash, who is the chief? Guy Ryder, Guy, G-U-Y, Guy Ryder, R-Y-D-E-R, Guy Ryder, Guy Ryder, in brackets, Britain, Britain, B-R-I-T-A-I-N, Britain. Last one, where is the headquartered? Geneva, Geneva, G-E-N-E-V-A, Geneva. Next, look at the second choice, UNHCR. United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. For Refugees. United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees. India Republic. 1950. Established 1950. Next. Head. Filippo Grandi. Filippo, F-I-L-I-P-P-O, I repeat, F-I-L-I-P-P-O, Filippo Grandi, G-R-A-N-D-I, Filippo Grandi, Filippo Grandi, in brackets, where is he from? He is from Italy, Italy. Okay, head office, huh? Geneva, UNHCR, Geneva, like 1, 2 is also in Geneva. Choice 4, UNICEF, you know the full form, no? United Nations Children's Fund, United Nations Children's Fund, United Nations Children's Fund, dash, United Nations Children's Fund, dash, 1946, UNICEF 1946, the chief is Henrietta Fore, Henrietta, H-E-N-R-I-E-T-T-A, I repeat, H-E-N-R-I-E-T-T-A, Henrietta Fore, F-O-R-E, Fore, Henrietta Fore, in brackets, in brackets, America, US, US, New York City, head office, New York City, IAEA, International Atomic Energy Agency, International Atomic Energy Agency, International Atomic Energy Agency, dash, 1957, dash, Rafael Grossi, R-A-F-A-E-L, R-A-F-A-E-L, Rafael Grossi, G-R-O-S-S-I, Rafael Grossi, dash, oh, where is he from? He's from Argentina, Argentina, A-R-G-E-N-T-I-N-A, Argentina, Rafael Grossi, Argentina, dash, dash, where is it, what, Vienna, V-I-E-N-N-A, V-I-E-N-N-A, Vienna, comma, Austria, A-U-S-T-R-I-A, Austria, chalte. In which city has Oracle recently launched its second data center after Mumbai? I mean, this is India based, okay? Hyderabad is where they launched, yeah. Oracle, you could write Oracle Corporation, dash, world's largest world's largest relational database management system maker. World's largest relational database management system maker, RDBMS maker. Okay, RDBMS maker. Next, head office, Redwood City, REDWOOD, Redwood City, comma, California, comma, US. Dash, CEO, SafraCats, SAFRA, SafraCats, CATZ, SafraCats. Next, chalte hain. The Union Cabinet has approved a proposal to establish a National Financial Reporting Authority. It functions as an independent regulator of the auditing profession. Till date, there is no regulatory independent regulator of the auditing profession. There is ICAI, that is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, but it's more of a governing body. This is the regulator, basically. Okay. So I think we'll just leave this here. Not much is known about this. On which of the following is the highest interest rate charged by commercial banks? Oh, plenty of interest rate is charged on credit cards. Credit cards, the interest rate could be anywhere between 40 to 44% per annum. Okay, yeah, I'm not kidding. If you don't use them wisely, you are out. That is, any person who does not use them wisely, the person's out. Maybe I will discuss this more in the next class. This and something else I have in mind. So we will discuss those two things in the next class. But credit cards, see crop loans could, given by commercial banks would carry an interest rate of 8% to 18%. I mean, 8 to 13% crop loans. There are some loans, crop loans that, Kisan loans that come at 3%, 4%, but those are highly subsidized, very, very small amount, about 20,000 rupees, 40,000. We are not talking, I'm talking about mainstream loans, crop loans, okay? Fasal Rin, the interest rate on crop loans could be anywhere between 8 and 13%. Educational loans, again, 9 to 14%, but if you look at SBI, it's about 10.25% for up to 7.5 lakh and about 10.5% for, anything above 7.5 lakhs. So still reasonable. But this is what they call fixed rate of interest. Okay. Other banks give floating rate of interest, which can change depending on the market interest rate. So, home loans normally carry lower rate of interest than credit card. Credit cards are extremely expensive if you don't know how to use them. We'll come back to this, okay? I'll discuss this, how a credit card works and everything in a very different way. Maybe over the next two classes, not, I won't promise you, but I'll bring it. The Union government has extended Raj Kiran Rai's term as the CEO of the Union Bank of India. Union Bank of India, UBI. So, guys, NABARD, who is the CEO? Chintala Govindarajanu. Chintala, C-H-I-N-T-A-L-A. Chintala Govindarajanu. Govindarajanu, one word. G-O-V-I-N-D-R-A-J-U-L-U. Govindarajanu. Punjab National Bank. S.S. Mallikarjun. Then Bank of India. Atanu Kumar Das. Indian Bank. Padmaja Chunduru, C-H-U-N-D-U-R-U, Chunduru.
Some of these questions are very easy. Look at this one. Which of the following is the process for checking the creditworthiness of an applicant for loan, etc.? Credit appraisal. Credit appraisal means is a, what banks try, what the lender tries to do is whether the person is creditworthy. Means, can I extend a loan to this person? Will the loan come back to me? Does the person have the repayment capacity? Does the person have a stable income? Has a good financial track record of paying loans and other making other payments on time? All that stuff. So banks look at, you know, credit worthiness of an individual, and that process is called credit appraisal. Okay. So John Castex, you can say Jean also. John Castex is the new Prime Minister of France. Who are the prime ministers of these places? Yeah. Who is the president of France? In France, the president is the most powerful guy. Okay. France has a president named Emmanuel Macron. Emmanuel, E-M-M-A-N-U-E-L. Emmanuel Macron, M-A-C-R-O-N. Emmanuel Macron. What about these choices? Spain, Prime Minister is Pedro Sanchez. Pedro, P-E-D-R-O. Pedro Sanchez, S-A-N-C-H-E-Z. S-A-N-C-H-E-Z. Sanchez, Pedro Sanchez. Next, Portugal. There is a president here. It's a presidential system. Rebelo, R-E-B-E-L-O, Rebelo, the full name is Marcelo Rebelo de Souza, but you could write Rebelo D-E, Rebelo D, Souza, S-O-U-S-A, S-O-U-S-A, so Rebelo de Souza. Norway, it's a constitutional monarchy, there is a Raja here. If you look at the Prime Minister, Erna Solberg, E-R-N-A, Erna Solberg, S-O-L-B-E-R-G, Solberg, Erna Solberg. Next, France, Netherlands, it's a tiny country, the Prime Minister is Mark Rutte, M-A-R-K, Mark Rutte, R-U-T-T-E, R-U-T-T-E, Mark Rutte. Next. Which company has launched a new program called Global Bharat to enable Indian micro, small and medium enterprises to become globally competitive by equipping them with digital technologies? That's a very good idea, na? Yes. SAP. SAP ne kehna chahiye, SAP kehna chahiye. SAP is a German company. You just write the CEOs of these guys, okay? CEOs. Christian Klein. Christian Klein. K-L-E-I-N. K-L-E-I-N. Christian Klein. Siemens. Joe Kaeser. J-O-E. Joe Kaeser. K-R-A-S-E-R. Kaeser. Adobe, E pronounce karna chahiye, E ko pronounce karna chahiye, not Adobe, Adobe, okay? Adobe, it has an Indian CEO. Shantanu Narayan. Xerox, John Vicentin, John, J-O-H-N, in some places you will find J-O-N, both are okay. John Vicentin, V-I-S-E-N-T-I-N, I repeat, V-I-S-E-N-T-I-N, John Vicentin. Xerox is a huge, not exactly huge in the sense, but among office equipment companies like printers, you know, what we call scanners, you know, photocopiers, this is world-class company, okay? So, John Vicentin,
Netflix, the guy who founded, he's also a CEO. Reed Hastings, R-E-E-D, Reed Hastings, H-A-S-T-I-N-G-S, Reed Hastings. See, it's, you sometimes don't require the CEOs, the head officers. Like for example, Netflix is headquartered in a place called Los Gatos in California. Xerox is in Norwalk. What is it? Connecticut. Kuch time, nahin dekhte. Okay, sometimes we will not write. Which bank has launched the e-Kisan Dhan app for farmers across India to access a bouquet of agriculture and banking services on the mobile? HDFC Bank. I saw this app actually. I went to the website of HDFC Bank. I saw it, what they offer. Everything, loans, for what, eligibility for loans, everything is mentioned there. Okay. So, CEO is Aditya Puri. Aditya Puri. Canara Bank. What's the name here? Lingam Prabhakar. Prabhakar. Lingam Prabhakar. UCO Bank. UCO Bank. Atul Goyal. Atul. Atul Goyal. G-O-E-L. Bank of Baroda. Sanjeev Chadda. Sanjeev Chadda. Sanjeev Chadda, Sanjeev Mehta, Sanjeev Chadda, yeah. IndusInd Bank, Sumant Katpalia, Sumant Katpalia, Sumant Katpalia, K-A-T-H-P-A-L-I-A, Sumant Katpalia. I'm looking at the clock because we shouldn't exceed our time. What is an outdated check? A check that is more than 3 months old from the date of issue. Yeah, earlier it used to be 6 months. Now it is 3 months. So, you see the choices. There's nothing to discuss. Okay. Which of the following won the Diplomat Cup Cricket Championship 2020 held in Sharjah? Sharjah is in the United Arab Emirates. The Indian consulate won the Diplomat Championship. Australia, Sri Lanka, Zimbabwe. एक काम करते हैं जिम्बाब्वे के बारे में लिखते हैं हमने कभी लिखा नहीं है वी हैवंट रिटन मच अबाउट जिम्बाब्वे एनी टाइम इनफैक्ट वी हैव नेवर रिटन अबाउट जिम्बाब्वे राइट जिम्बाब्वे द कैपिटल इज हरारे एच ए आर ए आर ई हरारे द प्रेसिडेंट इज एमर्सन ई एम आई रिपीट ई एम M-E-R-S-O-N, Emerson, Mangangwa, M-N-A-N-G-A-G-W-A, M-N-A-N-G-A-G-W-A, Mangangwa. Some places you will find M-N-A-N-G-A-N-G. N-G-W-A. You don't write, you know, the last N, it's okay. Don't worry. I have seen both the spellings. The currency there is called RTGS dollar. Zimbabwe RTGS dollar. Real-time gross settlement dollar. Yes, yes, that's the full form. RTGS dollar. आप ये सब कुछ एक्सेप्ट करता है डॉलर साउथ अफ्रीकन रैंड यू नेम बोट्सवाना पुला एवरीथिंग इज एक्सेप्टेड ओके चलिए सिंडिकेट बैंक हैज मर्ज विद शैल वी राइट अबाउट मर्जर्स चलिए काम करते हैं वी एंड द क्लास ऑफ मर्जर्स आई डिडंट वांट टू डिस्कस दिस आई थॉट वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन बट चलिए कोई बात नहीं फटाफट राइट सिंडिकेट बैंक एक काम करते हैं यू राइट द बैंक दैट आर मर्ज विद द वंस ऑन द राइट ओके द वंस ऑन द राइट विल बी द मेन बैंक यू कैन राइट द टाइप एट टू कॉलम्स टॉप कॉलम टू टॉप कॉलम Merged bank, M-E-R-G-E-D, merged bank, first column, underline that. Second column, anchor bank, anchor, A-N-C-H-O-R, anchor bank, means just we merge with it. The main bank is the anchor bank, okay? So, syndicate bank dash Canara Bank. Syndicate bank dash Canara Bank. Yeah. Allahabad Bank merged with Indian Bank. Allahabad Bank, next column, Indian Bank. First column, next point, first column, Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank. Or Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank dash with Union Bank of India. Union Bank of India, choice 2. Union Bank of India. Next. OBC, Oriental Bank of Commerce. Oriental Bank of Commerce and United Bank of India. United Bank of India dash. What is that? Punjab National Bank. That's it. That should be fine. Yeah. So you know which bank has merged with which bank. Okay. There is one more actually, but we will come back to it later. Okay. That was the last question. Chali, that's it, guys. Have a lot of fun. Thanks for being here. And make sure that you share your feedback like Kaushik did. And I just don't know how I skipped that particular part. Thanks once again for being here. Have a lot of fun. Stay curious. Enjoy yourself.